Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy.
In this lecture, let us understand periodic signal and non-periodic signal. A signal x of t is said to be periodic signal if it repeats itself after a regular interval of time. A continuous time signal x of t is said to be periodic signal if it repeats itself after regular intervals of time. So if we take time interval, as delta t, we can take delta t as capital T. Here capital T is known as fundamental period. So which means the signal x of t should repeat itself after fundamental period t. So we can write the signal should satisfy the condition x of t plus t is equal to x of t for all the values of t from minus infinity to infinity. So this is the condition for signal to be periodic signal. So let us take this as equation number 1. So here fundamental period is the time taken by the signal to complete one cycle. So to complete one cycle, it will take time period t. After this time period t, the signal should repeat itself. Such type of signals are known as periodic signal. We can write fundamental frequency of signal. Fundamental frequency f is equal to 1 by t. Unit of frequency is hertz. We can write fundamental angular frequency. Omega will be equal to 2 pi f. Since f is equal to 1 by t, we can write omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Now let us write the example for periodic signal. So this is the example of continuous time signal, which is a periodic signal. So you can see this signal is having a fundamental period of t. So this is one cycle of the signal. After this fundamental time period, the signal is repeating itself. That's why this signal, you can call this as periodic signal. And the condition is it should be periodic for all the values of t from minus infinity to infinity. So this signal should be periodic from minus infinity to infinity. Only then we can say the signal as periodic signal. Similarly, for discrete time signal, we can write the signal will be periodic signal if it satisfies the condition x of n is equal to x of n plus n for all the values of n from minus infinity to plus infinity. And the angular frequency of this discrete time signal can be given as 2 pi by capital N. This is the example of discrete time signal, which is a periodic signal. So fundamental period of this signal will be n is equal to 5 samples. So which means after 5 samples of signal, the signal will repeat itself. You can see, so here it is 0 to 1, we can take it as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So after 5 sample, it is repeating itself. And this signal should repeat from minus infinity to infinity so that it should satisfy the condition of periodicity. Now let us see non-periodic signal. Any continuous time signal that doesn't satisfy equation 1 is a non-periodic signal. So if x of t plus capital T is not equal to x of t for all the values of t, such type of signals are known as non-periodic signals. So let us take a continuous time signal. You can see this signal is starting from 0 and it is up to 2T. After this, it is not repeating. This type of signal is known as non-periodic signal. If we take, for example, this signal is started from 0 and it is repeating itself up to infinity, even then the signal is non-periodic because it is not satisfying the condition minus infinity to infinity. So the signal has to repeat itself from minus infinity to be a periodic signal. That's why even though the signal is starting from 0, if it is repeating up to infinity, the signal is non-periodic signal. So this is very important concept you need to remember. Similarly, for discrete time signal, if x of n is not equal to x of n plus n for all the values of n, we'll call the signal as non-periodic signal. You can see this signal is not repeating itself, so that's why we can call this discrete time signal as non-periodic signal. This is all about periodic and non-periodic signal. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.